Mr. Gunther?
Canto, okay, cut the tongue off. What a shame. I really liked you.
Liked?
So be it.
Thank you.
was there.
Stop undressing on my account, lady.
Really?
I don't mind at all. You just keep on peeling away. I like that red. Looks real hot. Matches your lips. Ooh, I like this too. Sweet. Kinda slutty. You know what I like better than nasty red bras like this? I like it better when they're off.
You know what I'd like? I'd like it if for once you'd use the door instead of climbing in the window.
Hello? I came to see about the vacant apartment.
It's been rented.
Creep.
No, really, no, it's all right. I'll just pick it up myself. Thank you.
Hi, are you the owner?
Yes.
I came to see about the apartment. Is it still vacant?
As a matter of fact, it is.
May I take a look at it?
Why not?
Hey, do I know you from somewhere?
No, I don't think so.
Sure?
If you have a face, I think I'd remember.
You're a beautiful woman.
Thank you. My name is Laurie Bancroft.
You don't mind if I don't shake? This way, please.
Pretty girl.
Yeah. Mr. Gunther always rents to the pretty ones. What do you suppose his secret is?
How do you mean?
Well, everyone has a dark secret. I just wonder what his is.
It's wonderful. I love it. It's just the right size. It's affordable. It's not anything like that creepy old haunted house I lived in last year. What a nightmare. I'm convinced the man across the hall was a vampire. Well, maybe he wasn't a real vampire, but... You know what I like best about this place?
I have no vampires.
It's good. No, I like it because it's walking distance to school. You do rent to college students, don't you?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I do. If I find they are the right choice for the apartment, I try to be selective.
Well, that's good. You should be selective. This is a great kitchen.
Will you take it?
Pardon?
The apartment, will you take it? I need to know now.
Sure, I'll take it. It's perfect.
It's a deal, then?
Well, you bet. It's a deal.
May 8th, 1986. I used to kill in the name of science. Now, I kill because I'm addicted to killing. It's the only way I can feel alive. Now, Mother, let's see. Where was I? It's the part where I talk about Father sending Mother and me to Argentina in 1944. June 1953. I finished medical school and begin my practice. Mom, this isn't good if you don't eat. Come here, please. You must eat, Mother. I can't kill you. Who would I talk to if you're dead?
Hi, Carl.
Hi.
Hey, could you give me a hand?
Sure.
The sweet tooth.
Oh, they were on sale.
Sack full?
Oh, why is it I can never find my key?
Oh, I have a master key. What would you do?
Oh, I'm such a goofball sometimes.
There you are.
Have a glass of wine, Carl?
Oh, no alcohol. I don't drink alcohol. It poisons the body.
Oh, it's a small vase, Carl. Everybody has at least a few vases. Don't you have any vices?
Like what?
Oh, I don't know. The usual. Drugs. Gambling. Fast cars. Women. Well?
Well?
Well, say something.
I had women. Okay? Didn't work out.
Jessica here is our most famous tenant.
Really? What are you famous for, Jessica?
I'm a soap opera actress. I play a soap opera actress on a soap opera.
Are you serious?
I'm afraid so.
Here, Laura, try this on for size.
What is it?
Tequila milkshake. Oh, come on.
What do you think?
Sorry, stuff I ever tasted.
Oh, it is, but honey, it does wonders for your woes. With a guy with any sort of regularity, he disappears on me. Without so much as a... It's been nice knowing you, Harriet, but I got to be moving on. My latest fella and me, we were just starting to get good at it when he just up and whoosh, gone like a fart in a storm. Well, I didn't mind that he was undependable, unemployed, uncivilized, uncouth, uncool, and lazy as a pig.
From the sound of it, Harriet, you were probably better off.
Alone again is never better off. Wait. And now this poor little old pitiful as a dog me shit. Drink up!
Man.
Scary like that.
Sorry, I didn't mean to.
Mr. Gunther, I hate to bother you this late at night. Would you mind going down to my apartment?
Sure.
Well, there's a strange noise.
Vampires?
No, not this time. More like The Exorcist.
Would you like to come in, Lori, for a moment?
No. Thank you, Mr. Gunther. It's late.
Are you sure?
Well, I only came up here because I was disturbed by the noise.
Oh, probably the rats.
Isn't there something you can do?
Sure, I'd take care of it.
Thank you.
Are you sure you don't know what to do?
No. Thank you, Mr. Gunther. Good night.
Good night, Lori. I was chief surgeon at the National Hospital when I began practicing euthanasia. As a doctor, I was able to end their pain by mercy killing. Then, in 1971, a very strange thing happened. I began reading my father's diaries and was shocked to learn that euthanasia was the same word he used as an excuse to kill Jewish people. Euthanasiengruppen. Thanks God I have a sense of humor. Makes life much easier. If you can love.
We don't have to love forever, just tonight. To say sweet whispers just tonight. We don't have to be true lovers, just kiss me tonight. We don't have to hold each other just tonight. We don't have to say I love you just for tonight. Lovers tonight, hold me tonight. Make me believe me tonight.
I'm coming, Sophie.
Don't make me feel like a fool. Don't think that I would ever.
Hank Peterson, will you quit playing around and just get in here? I'm hot. Hank.
Thank you. Dr. Gunther. Dr. Gunther.
My name is Joseph Steiner. Do you remember me?
Yes.
May I come in?
Please let me alone.
Dr. Gunther, I have spent 3 years looking for you. You should know by now that I'm a very tenacious man. You were not easy to find, but I found you. And I am not going to go away.
Just a moment.
You are a murderer, Dr. Gunther. Well, I can't prove it. Not yet, anyway. But during the 5 years you were the chief resident at the National Hospital in Buenos Aires, 67 people admitted under your care with routine illnesses died. And as you know, Dr. Gunther, one of those 67 was my brother.
Mr. Steiner. I've been a doctor for 27 years. I delivered babies. I healed the wounded and I cured the sick every day of my life. Surely, some of my patients died. One of them was your brother. I'm sorry about that. But I'm only a doctor.
Do you recognize this man? Einfeld, SS officer Karl Werner Reitlinger, principal designer of the instruments of torture used in the Einsatzgruppen and in over 100 concentration camps, executed in 1945 by the International Military Tribunal for crimes against humanity. This is a picture of your father, isn't it?
Mr. Steiner, I'm going to ask you to leave.
Dr. Gunther.
Mr. Steiner. I ask you to leave. Goodbye.
Dr. Gunther, I will be watching you.
December 8th, 1973. I have been practicing euthanasia as routinely as I perform my other everyday medical procedures. February 17th, 1974. Due to a clerical error, I mistakenly terminated the life of a perfectly healthy man. A quick, undetected injection and his heart stopped. To my surprise, I did not feel remorse. Instead, I began to understand the unusual sensations my father described in his writings. Killing is my heroin, my opiate, my fix. It gives me a godlike sensation that goes beyond that special feeling doctors have because they can save lives. When you can take life away as easily as you can give it, that is a feeling very few people ever experience.
You are really a difficult woman, Martha. I haven't even touched him yet. Do you want some of it? I'm a happy man, Martha.
Just a sec, let me find the switch.
Nice place. How's your touch?
Thank you. Can I fix you a drink?
Yes. Tonight would be a good night to drink. A lot.
Do you go to the ballet often?
About as often as I'm audited by the IRS.
How often is that, Alfred?
Too often. Both experiences are terribly boring.
Oh, is that what we were? Bored. Sometimes culture confuses me, and I think I'm having a good time. Anyway, that's the way I felt tonight at the ballet.
You enjoyed the ballet?
Oh, no, not at all.
You see, that's what confused me.
The ballet confused you?
No, culture confuses me. I just wasn't certain it was boring until you told me about the IRS.
Jessica, I have no idea what you're talking about. But I find you absolutely charming.
Aren't I?
I like you, Jessica.
I like you too, Alfred. You remind me of my Uncle Morris. What a rotten human being. Oh, I didn't mean you were rotten, Albert. I just meant...
Alfred,
I mean, you're just like, older, you know? Like my rotten Uncle Morris. Sorry. Why don't I, slip into something more comfortable?
Yes, why don't you?
Doing, Alfred?
I heard this, I can't quite describe it. Well, it sounded like a tap, tap, tapping.
Mice.
Mice?
Baby mice. You get used to it.
Survived four wives. I'm rather fond of it myself.
Just how rich are you, Alfred?
Does it matter to you that I'm rich?
Well, yes, it does matter to me if you were rich or not. See, I wouldn't have gone out with you in the first place if you weren't. But don't be offended by that, because I don't go out with anybody unless they're rich.
Jess. You are absolutely an original.
Yes, I am.
What the hell is that?
The baby mice.
Jessica, I just cannot make love with that sound. I'm really very sorry. And if I were you, I'd talk to your landlord about hiring an exterminator.
Documented my killings in order to explore this addiction to death. And lately I have begun to wonder if I have fallen from grace with the world.
Thank you.
Hi.
Excuse me for disturbing you, Miss Bancroft. My name is Joseph Steiner. I spoke with you earlier on the phone.
Oh, right. Right. Come in.
Personally, I can't stand smokers. They're a nasty hazard to society.
Well, then why do you smoke?
Compulsive personality type, I suppose. As I told you earlier on the phone today, I was investigating the landlord, Dr. Carl Gunther. And part of that investigation involves getting certain information from some of his tenants.
Yes, well, I don't know if I can help you. As you can see, I just moved in here a few days ago.
We're Laurie Bancroft, age 26, born in Tucson, Arizona, journalism student at Brown University, single, both parents living in Santa Fe, New Mexico. Your father is editor of the Santa Fe Chronicle. Your sister Kay died when she was only 4.
Just exactly who are you investigating, Mr. Steiner?
I believe Dr. Carl Gunther killed my brother.
Okay. Mr. Steiner, or whoever you are, I think you better leave.
Miss Bancroft, I have spent 3 years trying to prove Dr. Carl Gunther killed my brother. I just need a few more pieces of the puzzle.
Look, I don't know you, and I don't know anything about Dr. Gunther, and I'd rather not get involved.
Miss Bancroft, you are involved. There's something going on in this building. I don't know what it is, but I think you can help me find out.
Mr. Steiner, I don't know what kind of axe you have to grind with my landlord, but I just as soon not be part of it.
No, it should be painful. Miss Bancroft, I don't mean to alarm you, but I would be concerned about your safety in this building. Dr. Gunther?
May 9, 1986. Like my father, I'm fascinated by the delicate balance between life and death. Good and evil.
So be it.
Kamerad, woher stammst du?
Aus Friesenland.
Und du, Kamerad?
Aus Schlesien.
I'm my own God. My own jury. My own executioner.
Von der Donau, vom Rhein.
Und von der Saar.
Ein Wolf, ein Führer.
Heil Günther! Bathtub.
What?
warned of the rats.
Deutschland! Wir folgen Deutschland!
Oh, God.
So be it.
Thank you.